Desperate for quick cash, copper thieves are risking everything, even their lives.
You know, it's become a huge problem here in the metro, and now police have their own unit to bust copper thieves. KOCO's Matt Garcia has an exclusive look into their dangerous world.
Lives lost, service cut, and possibly higher power rates, all for a piece of metal. And as you will see here, it's a whole new world out there. The thieves are getting more daring.
These are the images of a growing crime in the metro.
And this pole that we have right over here.
That OG&E security manager, Jason Kuhn, is working hard to stop. Kuhn showed us two locations hit this month. On South Portland, thieves chopped down an electrical pole, causing an outage to a nearby apartment complex and a grass fire.
They set it on fire initially to try to bring the pole down to get their hands on the copper inside the transformer.
And while there, look what we found, the suspect's axe.
Copper wire wrapped around it.
At the second location, thieves cut through a fence to steal grounded copper wire at the substation at Northwest 23rd and Shields Boulevard.
How much did they steal?
They stole about 97 feet of copper off our structures, and which will be at $3.50 a pound. Won't get much out of it. It'll cost us somewhere around $4,000 to fix what they've done.
This type of crime compromises the substation, power to service at homes like yours, and set back OG&E millions of dollars. While OG&E won't say that cost directly impacts rates, they do say someone has to pay for it.
Last year alone, OG&E suffered about $2 million in repair costs for these substations and lines that they have to go in and repair or replace after they're done.
What do thieves do with the copper? Sell it as scrap at recycle centers like Metal Check on South High. The Oklahoma City Police Department's new metal theft unit showed us what goes down. You see these guys at the white truck? Listen as they explain suspicious-looking copper wire to Inspector Marty Stupka.
See, they can't buy burnt wire.
Right, right. We didn't know that.
We didn't know that there. I didn't know that.
Okay, but you didn't burn it, did you?
No.
It was in the dump.
It was all burned up already. We was just going through it.
Copper in the dumpster is one of the biggest lines thieves give to recyclers. Now new laws require recyclers to ask sellers for ID, proof of ownership, and bill of sale.
They have to show that they actually own it. Finding property doesn't make you the owner.
The illegal sale of any amount of copper is a felony, punishable by up to 5 years in prison and a fine of $2,500. It's not just the new penalty that Stupka and Kuhn hope deter criminals, but the dangerous risk involved. We can't show you the entire image because of their graphic nature, but look what a wrong move did when two crooks tried to steal copper from a transformer in South Oklahoma City. They were electrocuted in seconds.
Absolutely. The danger is not only to the general public and our members to repair it, but also the guys who are stealing as well.
The new metal theft unit appears to be doing its job. So far, it has doubled the number of copper theft arrests made a year ago. The state is looking to follow the city's lead in cracking down on copper theft. Matt Garcia, KOCO, Eyewitness News 5.
And Matt tells us police are happy with the recycling facilities in Oklahoma City. They say they're getting 100% cooperation from them.